everyone. My name is Jen Priester, and my website is newbornsbyjen.com. And I'm a photographer, and I mostly photograph newborns and families and children and babies. And today I'm going to do a tutorial on how I started with this image and ended with this image with snow. So before we get started, I just want to say it's important when you do this shot to have a specific kind of background when you're doing this. It's very hard to get this look when you have grass. I don't know why. The grass just looks weird. Kind of looks like frost. Here's an example. So this is a picture with a baby that was in grass, and it was, I think it was May. And so it was pretty, you know, I live in Michigan, so it was probably like 60 or 70 degrees that day. It wasn't too cold, maybe 70. And whenever you do this effect on grass, it just kind of looks like frost or something. It doesn't really look like snow. So it's important to have a specific kind of background when you're doing this. So to get started, excuse me, the first thing I'm going to do is I'm actually going to edit. She had a cut on her face, so we're going to edit that right now. This is a really great family. I've been working with them for many years. I'm using the patch tool here. She had a little accident, so we're going to fix that. Okay, fixed it. All right, so we're going to get started. First thing I'm going to do is I'm going to push W, which will over here. It's called the quick selection tool. And what we're going to first do is we're going to select all of them. This kind of is a little bit tedious, but the more that you, the more correctly that you do it, the better it'll look. And, you know, later on when you're doing the picture. So I'm going to do a specific, fine, tedious job here so you can see how to do it. All right. So we're going to, and if you're wondering how, I don't know why my Photoshop's being slow. If you're wondering how to make it bigger and smaller like this, it's the button that's next to your P. I don't know what, they look like brackets or something. And that'll fix that there. So we're going to have to take out all of the parts that have green. So, and we're going to be fixing this later. Okay, that's good. There's a part up here. I might just actually do this later because it's kind of small. All right, what happened here? All right, we're going to get the hair. Okay. And that's good. Okay. Now we are going, let's fix this part right here and get his hair, get his shirt here. Sometimes this tool doesn't work the best. Make sure we got his jeans and everything. All right, and we're going to fix this part down here by his feet as well. Doesn't have to be perfect because we're going to fix it later, but the more, the better job that you do now, the easier it's going to be later, and you'll see what I mean. All right, I think this is good. Get this part of her shoe here. We can worry about this part later. I'm not really too worried about it. Get his shoe here as well. We could get a shoelace too. Okay. Get her hand and her wedding ring. But this tool is amazing. I use this all the time. Usually doesn't take this long, but all right. Okay. Now we're going to hold down the shift button on your keyboard, and then you're going to click select, and you're going to click selected mask. Or wait. Yeah, it should be selected mask. Yeah. Okay. Used to be the refine edge tool. All right, so now we're going to go zoom in, and we are going to go around all of the edges here. It does a pretty good job usually, not always. We want to get their hair and everything. Let's get her hair and his hair. Yeah, I don't really know why my Photoshop's being slow, but I guess we'll just have to deal with it. Okay, so this looks good. I don't really need to go around this. Looking at the edges here. His feet look good. Oops, I didn't mean to do that. We can see, you know, this part here pretty much looks the same. All right, legs, go down, look at the edges here. If you want to try this part right here, you can. See what it does? Didn't really do anything, so we'll skip that. Oh, wait, no, yeah. Okay, shoe. It's usually hit or miss. Sometimes it works really well, and sometimes it is crazy, and you're like, oh my gosh, Photoshop, what were you thinking? Okay, this is good. And I think I did his hair already. All right, now we're going to click OK. And we're going to hold down the Command button or Control if you're on a Windows, and you're going to hold the Command button and click J, so it's going to copy the layer. Actually, no. No, I was right. Sorry. I was getting ahead of myself. All right. And now we're going to make a new layer just because I like to work in layers. And what we're going to do now is we are going to go to Select at the top, and then you're going to click Color Range. And you're going to just click a color, you know, around here. And you want it to be white. The white parts are going to be the part that are going to turn into snow. So you're going to click, you know, you can look and just see what it does. You want a lot of white. So as you can see here, there's lots of white there. Here, not as much, right? So you want there to be lots of white. All right, so let's do this again. That's good. That's probably good. All right, click OK. And then you're going to go at the top again up here, and you're going to click Edit, Fill. And then you're going to click on white, click OK. And then you're going to hit Command D to deselect. And that's actually pretty realistic right there. You can even play with it. You know, usually you can't really minimize it because it's going to look weird. So, and I guess what we can do is we'll show you one more with less white just so you can see the difference. So do it again. Click Select, Color Range. And you can move this as well just to make more. But we're going to have a little bit more black in it. All right. Edit, Fill, White, click OK, Command D. Okay, so this is the difference. So this is with lots of white. This is with a little bit less. So you kind of just have to play with it. Like here, I think it looks better with less white. Here, I don't know. It just kind of doesn't really look as good, in my opinion. You can even, you know, with both of the layers, you can even make it a little bit more white. So you can have, you know, just play around with it. Oops, I did zero. Okay, so you can just play around with it, see which one you like. I think I like it without it more. Okay, so now what we're going to do is we're going to put layer masks on both of these. We're going to zoom in, and now we're going to fix all these parts, okay? So we are going to paint here, and since this is white, we're going to use black. So hit X, and it'll bring it black. And we're going to kind of be tedious here, so, and I'm using this brush. Honestly, probably won't do 100 because I don't really, I think it can be better if you have a little bit lower, so maybe at about like 60 or so. And we're just going to brush, and you're going to do lots of brushing. You could even do it here if you want to be like super, you know. When I do these kinds of shots, I don't do tons of them because it would just be too tedious, you know. And like I said, you kind of need a specific background for this. So if you're thinking about doing this and you can't just go and reshoot people, you know, you can either, and I went out of the lines there. So you can either, you know, just go and, you know, bring a model to a location and, you know, test it out. But I think that these, you know, these kind of backgrounds are better. Grass is hard. Every time I've done grass, I just haven't really liked the way that it looked. So now, right now, I'm going to be doing all the tedious work parts. So if you want to fast forward the video to get to the end, then you're more than welcome. But if not, you can do this with me. All right. This. Okay, so now we got all the grass parts there, and you can even do a little bit more, you know, because there's still a little bit brown. And then we're gonna fix this here. It's funny because like all that coloring in kindergarten paid off. So, all right, now we're going to go up the edges and just look. And we're going to see, you can click this eyeball button over here just to see how, you know, how it looks before and after. We're going to use this one. I'll do it a lot usually because I want to make sure that I'm doing this correctly. So, okay. And you could even go here and get this part white. And as you can see, it kind of doesn't look exactly smooth. Now, remember, we're zoomed in at 400%. 100% is what you'd want to look at. So when you zoom out a little bit, you can see a little bit better of what it would look like. So never really go by what it looks like at 400% because you're going to be like, oh my gosh, that looks horrible. All right, so it looks like this edge here. I'm going to click X to get it back on white because I just want to fix that. Okay. All right. And just go up the edge. See her ring disappeared here. So rings are a little bit tricky because they're kind of a little bit, you know, transparent. So it doesn't have to be perfect. You don't want there to be green in it. But as you can see, you know, there's a little bit of green around it. But again, zoom out and that looks fine. Okay, let's go up the edge. Okay, so here you can see right here. It was a little bit soft, I guess is the right word. And then right here, we're going to turn this into white. Okay. All right. And this part, let's see here. That's white. We're going to do this edge, and then we're going to fix this part here so it's white. So as you can see, this is so much easier than, you know, years ago. I've actually been doing this for years. I'm coming up on my 8th year of business, and we did not have this amazing tool back then, so we used to have to do this very meticulously, and it was hard, and it took forever, and it was just very interesting. So I'm very grateful. If you did not do Photoshop back then, be glad. Trust me. All right, so we can fix this little edge here, and I'm just being super, like, you know, particular here. I mean, you don't have to be crazy. And then we're gonna go back and draw or color his ear back a bit. Okay, so zoomed out at, you know, even 100%, that looks good. All right, and we're gonna fix all of these edges around his hair. Zoom in. Oops, wrong color, I think. Nope, I'm on the wrong one, that's why. Sometimes it's confusing. Alright, hang on a second. I'm trying to get rid of these white. This is the one I need to be on. Nope. I think, honestly, if it's not working, I don't know if I can actually remove these white things here. I guess we could do something like this. Sometimes you just have to play with it and see, you know, what it does and all that. All right. There's a part here in his hair. Sometimes it's just a matter of looking and seeing what you have to do. Okay, so as you can see, I brought in a little bit of the dark color that was behind him, so let's see how that looks. And ultimately, like this. So that looks pretty good. Let me see if I like that. You know what? I think I like it without what I just did. Because see how it just looks more realistic because it's white behind them. So we're going to niche what I just did there. Oops. And wrong one again. I'm just going to fix the parts that I fixed earlier on his hair. Okay. And this is one thing that I like about doing this tool is it turned it white here. So, you know, as you can see, wrong one again. As you can see, it kind of just, to me, it looks a lot better, you know, with the white there. So, okay. So this is showing me. All right. Now, again, it's good that this turned it this whiter color because the background's white. so it looks realistic. If you want to just mess with it and just, you know, see how it would look, you know, you can always do that. Make it a little bit more white. All right, and then obviously we got to fix these parts here. Go in here, turning this light. It also helps that they have light hair. I can't honestly really imagine doing this with darker hair. All right, and we're going to fix the edges. All right, definitely got to fix his hair here. My goodness. I always go on the wrong ones. Hold on, let me get that off. There. All right. Oh my gosh, I did the wrong one again. All right, so we're going to fix his hair. And this is actually a great example of what I was just talking about with brown hair and how it looks. All right, let me see how this looks with her hair here, making this dark. All right, so we're going to zoom out and see. All right, so looks better white, right? All right, let's zoom back in, do the rest of this up here. This is just one of those things, again, where you're just gonna see how it looks and see if you like it. But that tool does a pretty good job. Yeah, so it looks good. Again, this people are not gonna, you know, zoom in super duper a lot and print their photo. You just want to make sure it looks good when you're looking at it. You can zoom in. You don't even really need to look at 100% for stuff like this, but. All right. Let's see here. So here. Okay. And. Fixing her hand here. Let me do that again because that was like the world's worst outline. One thing that I would love for Photoshop to do is stop. It always, if I go back, it'll put it on the actual picture and then you have to like fix it every single time. Just like I just did now. It does that. I don't know why it does that. Okay. And now we're gonna, I switched it back to white and we're gonna fix that there. Okay. All right, let's see here. Oops. Okay, now we're painting black again. We're gonna fix the edges here. And what you can do is, like right here, you can look and I can see that I would like more white here. So. Looks good, looks good, looks good. If you want to be super picky, you can fix this little part here. Looks good. There's a green part, finally. So as you can see, that tool works very well because we barely really had to fix any of this stuff. There's another greenish part. And if you want to just, you know, again, click the eyeball tool. It'll tell you what needs to be fixed. Hey, you can turn their jeans to a different color. Look at that. All right, now we're gonna, there's Photoshop doing what I said earlier again. Here, okay, we're gonna fix all these parts now, make them all white. And it's okay if you get a little bit on the shoes because it'll just look like the reflection. So you want there to be that. There's another part we're gonna make white. Not doing too much because I like the shadow that's there. There's a part in a shoe. And we're gonna click X to turn it back into white and fix the shoelace and X again. Okay, pants look good. Look good. And we're gonna do this and see that we can add a little bit more white here. Right. looks good. And X to fix that, X to go back. Okay. All right. This is where we started. All right, now we're going to go up to the part between mother, and son. And we're going to see if we can fix this part right here. And I'm not, I'm actually not using a mouse. I'm using a tablet, which is like a pen, basically. And so I'm doing this part here, and I'm not pushing down hard because I don't want to. So you'll see why if you have one. I almost wish that I could. Yeah, that's a little too. Let's go back. All right, let me go back, all the way back. All the way back. All the way back for the most part. Okay. Do a little bit less. All right, how's that? That's better. I think I actually might do this in a different, because I don't really like how that looks exactly. Let me try one more time. This is like the hardest part of this picture. This is what I worked on a while last time too. Because if you do it too much, it looks fake. If you do it not enough, it looks fake. So this one is like somewhat hard. I don't even know if I'm going to like this. I'm probably honestly going to end up doing this separately because I don't really like it. I don't really like exactly how this is. Okay. Yeah, I don't really honestly think I like that. I mean, it doesn't even have to be that light either. I don't know. We're gonna come back to this. I don't like how that looks. We'll come back, probably. I guess that doesn't look too bad. I think what I don't like is the edge. I don't like how the edge looks. Let me try fixing the edge. That might be why I don't like it. Oops, wrong color again, like always. Another confusing thing about Photoshop is they always, like, it seems like, you know, when you start, it's not always white. Sometimes it's black. So you always have to change the colors. Like, sometimes I'll be working a layer mask, and one of them will have a white layer mask, and one of them will have a black layer mask. And I have to switch it so many times, and it gets confusing. Whoops. All right, that looks better. Let's try it again. All right, so before, after, I end up doing this a lot. I think another problem, I think another problem that might help, let me see if this will help. Well, we'll come back to this. I think that looks a lot better. It looks pretty realistic. Okay. We're gonna go down one more time and look at our feet and make sure that we got all of the stuff white. And as you can see, it's really not super white, so we're gonna do it again. Because you want it to be white. Because in the winter, that's what happens. And that's why I'm doing this, because oddly enough, we don't have any snow yet in Michigan, and it's December, which is like unheard of, which I'm not complaining because I am not a southerner, or I'm not a northerner, I'm a south person or west person, so I was not raised in snow. I didn't live in snow until I was like in fifth grade, so I'm not a snow person at all. So eventually when we move back to the south, I can do these and get the beauty of snow without having to drive in it and shovel it, which is not fun. Okay. This. All right. That looks pretty good. All right, so far, before, after, before, after, before, after. That looks good. Okay, we're done with that part. And so I'm going to merge the layers because I don't need them open anymore. And now I'm just going to do some of my edits here. Let me see. I'm trying to see if I still have this. Oops. Nope, that didn't work. Well, apparently I just like did something weird to Photoshop. No, stop. Stop. I don't know. These look like actions. Okay. Well, I think we're going to have a weird looking Photoshop until I can figure out how to put it back like I had it. I hate when stuff like this happens. It's funny that it happened, like, while I'm doing a video. But it's literally never happened in my life. Alright, well, we're just gonna have to deal with white Photoshop. Okay, and after this, we are gonna just, I'm just gonna run an action here really quick. And just brighten them up and all this other stuff. That's another tutorial for another day. Let me go on the brighten one and fix her white arm. Okay, that looks good. And the last thing I'm going to do is I'm going to add a little more brightness, and I'm actually going to take a little bit of this red out, probably because it was cold. So they were a little red. And then we're going to lighten them. All right, and looks good. All right, and then the last thing that we are going to do is we are going to go to, sorry, I'm still trying to fix this. This thing is bugging me big time. What's going on here? Oh, that's why. All right, and the last thing we're going to do, I'm going to save this, is we are going to get some snow overlays. So I don't really remember where I got these. I've had them for years. Oops, wrong way. You have to make sure you pull it in correctly or it's going to do something weird. All right, and so to do this, when it's black like this, let me put this with this here. Alright, when it's black like this, I'm probably honestly going to have to make Photoshop there so I can see it over here. Alright, the first one I'm going to do is this extreme one, I call it. We're going to just drag it in there, click Command 0 and then Command T, hold down Shift and pull it like this. And like I said, I got these off of the internet years ago. I have no clue where I got them, but if you just Google snow overlays or you can make your own, then that's what you do. Okay, so here's the image. Push enter, and then you go over here and you click the screen, and it's going to turn it into snow. And obviously, I don't want snow in awkward places, so I'm just going to get the erase tool. I'll still keep it on their faces because otherwise it's not going to be realistic, but I'm going to take it off of the places that I don't. Like, I don't mind that. We don't want it on their eyes. We don't want, like, this one is just distracting. I don't mind that. And you can even just turn it on and off to see where it is. So, obviously, like I said, you want it on their faces, but you don't want, like, awkward, you know, right on their eyeball or whatever, because that's weird. All right, and then I'm adding two just because I can. So, same thing. And make it a little bit smaller. And screen again. And this one I'm actually going to lower the opacity because it's just a lot of snow. Because we don't need that much snow. So just, you know, makes it. So here's before, here's after. Just adds a little bit more. You know, and you can even take the erase tool and just, like, I don't want a ton of it on their legs. Don't want it on their faces, just for the background. So it looks good. Probably gonna, this one's distracting right here to me. There. Okay, so this is about what I would do to change it. It looks good now that I've added the snow right here. It looks good. If you really wanted to, what you could do is make a new layer, do some crazy hardcore curves, and then go down here and click on the layer mask, hit Command I. And sometimes all you just need to do for stuff like this is just add a little bit of brightness and lower the opacity, and that looks better. So that looks good. So this is about it. I might actually do the same thing again and add just a little bit more brightness to their faces, because since we're out in the snow, when you shoot in snow, people are very light because the snow, there's basically white snow everywhere that reflects light onto them. So you don't have a, you know, I mean, you have shadows, but not as much as you would have when you're shooting with a dark green backdrop or whatever. Or like this picture was brown. So just a little more brightness. And there we go. And so we'll save it. And so this is the before and this is the after. So again, make sure that you pay attention to, you know, the little details. And also, there's one more thing. So you can burn this a little bit if you'd like. So you're going to have it on shadows, make a new layer. Forgot about this, actually. And just go around everywhere. And we're going to lower the opacity. I don't actually want it that much on her pants, his pants. Okay. So this is the before and after. And just makes it look a little nicer, in my opinion. So I don't like that on his face, though. I don't like how it darkens their faces. Okay. So anyway, this is what I would do. So here's the before, and here's the after, and that is how you add a snowy backdrop to your pictures. Again, just make sure you pay attention to your background. You don't want, you know, just trust me on it with grass. You can do your own testing, but it's very hard to make it look good with grass. So if you can have any other kind of backdrop, these are needles, I believe, from pine trees that are dying because they fell. So that's a really easy one to do. So just do your own exploration and good luck. And if you want to share the pictures that you made in the comments, feel free to. I'd love to see them. So thanks for watching. Have a nice day.